Well, Simmons is looking to try to add depth to that team. He's also focused on expanding his own game. The Rookie of the Year was at an event in Philly this past weekend and spoke about how last season he wanted to play to his strengths, but now he's ready to do more. Simmons said, quote, "If you take jump shots, teams give you a little bit more respect and you're able to make more moves and dissect the defense. This summer, I've been working a lot on certain things that I'll definitely use. I've had 1 year of playing in the NBA, so for me personally, I know I have a lot more to give." So, Nick, do you expect Simmons to shoot more jumpers next year?
He better. I mean, he better. That was the flaw in his game. All these teams were sagging off of him. They knew he wasn't comfortable from the outside. When you watched the Sixers, you went, all right, can Simmons do it and consistently hit those jumpers when he needs to? And the answer was no. So he better start shooting more and better be comfortable with it when the season rolls around.
Yeah, the playoffs were an eye-opening experience for him. You can tell because when the real scouting came in, the fact that it affected the way he played. I think Ben Simmons' future is amazing. I've proudly voted for him for Rookie of the Year, and I didn't want to take my vote back just because Donovan Mitchell was awesome in the playoffs.
Yeah.
I firmly believe that this guy is going to be a high-level player for a long time. I firmly believe his shot will improve. Is he ever going to be a good three-point shooter? Probably not. But this is one of my favorite things to say. If anybody wants to sell Ben Simmons stock, I'm prepared to buy it.
Well, but the Sixers, they do need to focus on spacing out that floor a lot more because they lost a lot of shooting. I mean, I know they added Landry Shamet, who's supposed to be a dead-eye shooter, according to our researcher, Schwartzy. But they're going to need shooting from somewhere.
It's one of the reasons why Jamal Crawford's eyeing that situation because he can stretch the floor a little bit. And it's one of the reasons why Embiid has to go out to the perimeter a little bit because they need that floor balance. You know, I've talked to people in the league, and people are going to laugh at me when I say this, but I think it's interesting. Some people think that Ben Simmons might actually be kind of a point center because he has the ability to play and defend so well. He's got such great length.
All over the place.
Yeah, and that in that, you know, not necessarily in a starting lineup, but in certain rotations and certain situations, you could actually have him defend the center. And when you have a guy like that, a versatile guy like that, who can play all five positions, you've just got to be able to take advantage of all of this. And so it may take the Sixers a while to get this roster just right and to get their floor balancing just right. But, again, I'm really still excited about where they can go.
I mean, but we'll see what they can do to improve that roster, especially since they still don't have a GM in place.